recovery system, you must first check by which your transaction or the system may fail. Crash or recovery, your database may get crashed too because of the hardware error or software error or a power failure, right? DBMS is a highly complex system with hundreds of transactions being executed every second. The durability and robustness of DBMS system depends on its complex architecture and its underlying hardware and the software system. If it fails or crashes amid transactions, it is expected that the system would follow this some sort of algorithm or methodology or techniques to recover the lost data. So whenever the failure occurs into the system, there must be a mechanism to recover from it. So here in this particular topic, we are going to study that particular algorithm, recovery algorithm. Okay. So what are different failure into the system? Failure classification. To say where the problem has occurred, we generalize a failure into various categories as follows. One is transaction failure, next is system crash, third is disk failure. This may happen in databases. Your transaction failure occurs because of different reasons. A transaction has to abort when it fails to execute or it reaches a point where it can't go any further. This is called transaction failure, where only a few transactions or processes are hurt by the failure of that particular transaction. A transaction may be failed because of two types of errors that is happening into the system. One is logical error and another is system error. What is logical error? Where a transaction cannot complete because it has some code error or any internal error condition. Like divide by zero, it is a, you can say, logical error. If your logic is wrong while designing a software, the logical error always occurs. And suppose if your transaction is failed because of that logical error, then that can also be considered as a failure of the transaction. Then another is system error, where the database system itself terminates an active transaction because the DBMS is not able to execute it, or it has to stop because some of these system conditions. For example, in case of deadlock or resource unavailability, the system aborts an active transaction. Maybe you can say a hardware error, right? Or a deadlock according to the system. Resources are not available to do that transactions. Because of that, the system aborts the active transaction. This is called as failure of the transaction by system errors. Next is called as system crash. There are problems external to the system that may cause the system to stop abruptly and cause the system to crash. The system may crash by hardware error or software error. For example, interruptions happen because of the power failure. You are performing a transaction and suppose power goes off, then that may lead the transaction failure. Sometimes operating system errors are also going to crash your transaction. Because of that system, is entire system gets crashed. The last is very common failure, that is called as disk failure. In earlier days of technology evolution, it was a very common problem where hard disk drives or storage drives used to fail frequently. Disk failure include formation of bad sectors, unreachability to the disk head crash, or any other failure which destroys all or some part of the discharge. You might have noticed this particular failure problem. Sometimes your hard disk gets crashed. When this hard disk gets crashed, you always check for the bad sectors in your hard disk. Hard disk is always a combination of thousands of sectors, divided into thousands of sectors. The initial sector of the hard disk, if it gets crashed, then you can say the whole system of your hard disk is crashed. You cannot recover any data from such hard disk. And suppose the first sector is working fine, and some other sectors in between of the entire hard disk is corrupted or crashed, then we can still recover some data from such hard disk. And this type of failure is called as disk failure. Now, how to recover that transactions? If such transaction is failed due to some any error, how to record such transaction? So we have one method that is called as log-based recovery. Whenever the transaction gets failed, the DBMS software maintains a log. What is log is? Log is a sequence of records which maintains the records of action performed by a transaction. It is important that the logs are written prior to the actual modification and stored on a stable storage media, which is fail-safe. Right? So every log maintains any modification that the transaction does into the system, and always it is stored in a stable media, which is always safe. After that, by using those logs, a recovery can be possible. Then how a log recovery works, that we'll see now. There are only four steps that are there in the log recovery process. The first step is, the log file is kept on a stable storage media. When a transaction enters in the system and starts its execution, it writes a log about it. And the record that goes into the log file will be TN, start. TN is the transaction and start is the action it has initiated, right? Then the third step is, when the transaction modifies an item X of a database, then it writes that log as follows in the log file. That is TN, X, V1, V2. So here, T is the transaction, X is the data item, V1 is the old value of that data item, and V2 is the new value of that data item. It means that it reads TN as change the value of X from V1 to V2. Then the last statement that comes into the log file when the transaction completed, that is TN commit. TN, commit. So TN start is the statement when your transaction is actually started. TN commit is the statement when your transaction actually executed and committed successfully. In between, whatever the transaction does, any modification to the database will be recorded by an instruction TN, X, V1, V2. So TN is the transaction, whereas X is the data item, V1 is the old value of the data item, and V2 is new value of the data item. Now, there are two ways by which you can modify the database in the recovery process. The database can be modified using two approaches. First is deferred database modification. Deferred means the action will be executed after all the transaction completes. Right, everything is over, and then the modification of the database is done. Then that type of modification is considered as deferred database modification. In this, all logs are written on a stable storage, and the database is updated when the transaction commits. So it means that
It allows all the transaction to do modification into the database. If something goes wrong, after all the transaction gets executed, if something goes wrong, the referred database modification perform the recovery of the system by using the logs. The second way of log-based recovery is called an immediate database modification. In this method of modification, after every instruction from each and every transaction, the database gets modified. The database gets modified, and recovery is possible by using the log maintained in this format. So, in immediate database modification, each log follows an actual database modification. That is, the database is modified immediately after every operation in the transaction. So there is a difference between deferred database modification and immediate database modification. Deferred database modification happens only after all the transactions or the transaction is committed. Whereas immediate database modification performs the action immediately after every instruction of the transaction. Okay. There is one more thing called as checkpoint in this log-based recovery. Recovery with concurrent transaction. When more than one transaction is being executed in parallel, the logs are interleaved. At the time of recovery, it would become very hard for the recovery system to backtrack all the logs and then start recovering it. To use this situation, modern database modification, DBMS, uses the concept of checkpoints. Checkpoints are also known as save points in the database. So, after performing, suppose there are n number of transactions are happening in the system, you can put the checkpoints in between some transactions. After some transaction, you can put a checkpoint so that the partial rollback is allowed. Instead of canceling the whole schedule or a transaction, we can roll back to a partial, we can roll back partially to the checkpoint. So the transaction which happened successfully into the system, their modified data will be remained as it is, and there is no harm to that particular transaction. So it is possible because of the checkpoints only. Keeping and maintaining logs in real time and in real environment may fill out all the memory space available in the system. As this time passes, the log file may grow too big to be handled at all. Checkpoint is a mechanism where all the previous logs are removed from the system and stored permanently in a storage disk. Checkpoint declares a point before which the DBMS was in a consistent state and all the transactions were committed. So always checkpoint ensure that if you roll back to that particular checkpoint, till that checkpoint, your database is always in a consistent state. To understand this, we will see this diagram wherein there are four transactions are happening concurrently. Say if we put a checkpoint here before T1, right? And then suppose the failure occurs in the execution of transaction T4 here, then how this checkpoint help us to save some part of the database modification? Okay, when a system with concurrent transaction crashes and recovers, it behaves in the following manner. First of all, recovery system reads the log in the backward fashion, in the backward manner, from the end to the last checkpoint. It maintains two lists, that is called as undo list, and another is called as redo list. Undo list is used for canceling the action of the transaction or any modification it has done to the system, whereas there is another list called as redo list. It can be used to redo that transaction so that the successful transaction and the modification done by successful transaction should be saved into the database. If the recovery system sees a log record like tn start and tn commit in a transaction lifecycle, or just tn commit, it put that transaction into redo list. So redo list consists of all the successful transactions. So any transaction which has tn start in the log file as well as tn commit in the log file, then such a transaction is called a successful transaction and it has to be put into the redo list. Now let us see what is there in undo list. If a recovery system sees a log with tn start only but not tn commit or any abort statement, abort log is not found, then it puts that particular transaction into undo list. So these are the transaction which are just started but not committed. They get cancelled in between because of some errors. Such transaction has to be put into undo list. So the recovery system has two lists now. One is called redo list and another is undo list. In redo list, it has all the details of the successful transaction, whereas undo list has the information of all the unsuccessful transaction into it. Now all the transactions in the undo list are then undone. They get cancelled and their logs are removed from the system. Their logs are removed from the system. All the transactions in the redo list and their previous logs are removed from the system, and now they are redone before saving their logs into the system. It means that all unwanted logs of the undo list have been completely removed from the system, as well as the logs which are there into the redo list also gets removed first and then re-executed before saving the newly information into the logs. So it means that only successful transactions are carry forwarded and unsuccessful transactions are rolled back. So this way the recovery is possible into log-based recovery protocol or log-based